Welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe, and Lee and I are going to talk about some educational sites that are actually fun sites.
Not just educational.
Yeah.
Yeah. What I've got here is Google for Educators, but it's really Google for anybody.
Yeah, and we get there by going to google.com/educators. That easy.
Yeah. We've got tools for the classroom, classroom activities, classroom posters, Google Teacher Academy. I know some teachers who have gone to the Google Teacher Academy, and they are amazing teachers, and they've contributed to this site, and there are just some amazing resources.
Now, a lot of people don't realize how much these other companies do to improve education for us.
They don't realize.
You've got your Discovery Educators,
yes.
Google Educators, Microsoft has people, mm-hmm.
Apple has people.
Apple has,
right.
There's a lot of contributions.
VoiceThread has educator. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, corporate
educator
America
library.
Helps.
Yeah, oh, absolutely.
They
well,
are
it's
good.
In their best interest to make sure that their products are being put to good use.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, on the website here, we were looking through this earlier, and the tools for the classroom were awesome.
Yeah, and
you will
see these on Google if you go to Google and then click more and look over here. But these are specifically really useful in the classroom. For example, if you take a look over here, you've got book search and geoeducation, and this is the icon for
Google Earth.
Google Earth,
my favorite program.
Yes, I love it. And news, of course. And you've also got over here some very common Google tools.
Yeah, we talk a lot about these in the download section.
Yeah, that's right. And have you talked about Blogger already?
No, we haven't. Really.
Okay, we'll have to touch on that when we have some more time. But, you know, Blogger is just a free blogging software on Google.
What's a blog?
A blog is a weblog, okay, and you can basically just keep a journal online. I've got a class blog myself, and I also have a personal blog. The class blog is not using Blogger, but my personal blog is.
Yeah, you've used that for years, haven't
you? I have. I love it. It's Geeky Mama, and I just blog about educational stuff. But my class blog, since we're talking about educational uses, is just a great place where I post items about what we're doing in class or some things. If we're talking about hurricanes, for example, I'll go ahead and post something about hurricanes. And then my students go on and make comments. And then also other educators can go on and comment, and there's a conversation that ensues.
Really nice.
So it's a great way for teachers to create free blogs and can engage their students and their parents and the community.
And you really do have one of the top educational blogs in the United States.
Oh, stop.
You're good. You're
national known. Stop.
Okay, what else do we have there?
We've got Google Docs.
We're going to be talking about that in a few minutes.
We've got Google Docs, and there's resources here that will really help educators. So we've got a presentation that will give you an overview. We've got the basics, we've got tips and tricks, and we've got Google Docs in plain English, which is blocked. But what's wonderful about those in plain English videos, they're put out by Common Craft. They are about 2 minutes long, and they are really very simple videos. They're actually done with paper cutouts.
I've seen those. They're great.
They are. They're wonderful. And they're just so easy. They actually just move the cutouts around and explain in plain English, basically. And there's lots of topics there. Information about how students and teachers can use Google Docs. And those are collaborative. So it's kind of like having Word on your online. But you can invite people to collaborate.
It's cool. What else do we have for teachers in there?
So let's see. We've also got classroom activities.
Oh, nice. And they're broken down.
And they're broken down by grade level. Now, again, these are submitted by Google certified teachers. And for example, Nancy Sheroff, she's a Discovery Educator.
Okay.
So she's also a Google certified teacher, and she submitted a classroom activity here. We've got other people. There's Google posters, and here's another lesson. We've got lesson plans here for grades 6 through 12. Flying through the Crusades, postcards from the past.
So easy lesson plans for teachers to get just like that from top teachers in our country.
Absolutely.
That's great.
Absolutely. And you can also, if you click here to Google Teacher Academy, applications are closed for the next one, but you can apply to attend and join this group of teachers.
That is great.
And collaborate and learn and then become a part of that network of really dynamic teachers as well.
So this is a free website with lots of really great resources.
Yes.
That you might use if you're a teacher. Well, teachers should definitely
absolutely.
Be using it.
Absolutely.
If you're not a teacher, there's some fun stuff in here.
Yes, they sure are.
And if you have, grandchildren or children yourself,
mm-hmm.
this is a good way to make connections with
Google Forms, Google Spreadsheets, Google Docs, lots and lots of great tools. I encourage you to use
them. Google Toothpaste, Google everything.
Yeah, just about. Okay, another site that we're going to talk about that I've got over here on my computer is PuzzleMaker.com. And I can actually remember when this site started. This is way back in the early internet. We're talking when Mosaic and Firefox wasn't even out. It was Netscape back then.
Oh, my gosh.
Very few.
Well, you are.
Yeah, I'm old.
I know. There you go.
I go back further.
I didn't want to say it, Lee, but I'm glad you said it.
But this software used to be software that we purchased for our classroom.
I remember that. I hate to say it, but I do remember that.
And then after a while, this, I don't know what made them do it, but they gave up charging for it, and they gave it to us free online. And you can make crossword puzzles on here so easily. So, I mean, if you're an educator, this is a really great site. But if you just wanted to have fun for a party or something, or doing a family reunion, putting everybody's name in or where they're from, things like that, you just click on it, and we're blocked again, naturally. Didn't go to that level and try
it. But, you know, crossword puzzles are great. They are fun, but it's also a great way to reinforce vocabulary because it's not just a matter of, oh, here's the word, plug it in.
Yeah.
But it's also, you know, you can give a definition and ask the kids to then, you know, figure out the word and plug it in. It kind of adds an element of fun to something that may be, you know, a little difficult in the classroom.
Everybody loves crossword puzzles, right?
Yeah.
No, not really.
I do.
They're fun.
As long as they're not so hard.
But, yeah, well, that's just it. With this, you can make it fun. You could blend in things. If you're in a classroom setting, you could have spelling words along with, say, some of the students' names. You know, who got the top score in the spelling test last week? Neat thing to give an incentive for it.
Yes, yes. So, and kids, especially young kids, they all like to see their names.
Yeah, so PuzzleMaker.com, obviously a little bit of a trouble if you're doing it inside our district.
Well, I think we can work on that.
Yeah, I think we should.
That doesn't look like something that would normally be blocked.
That's a really good
set.
We can see the free demo works. And actually, that does work. We go to the free demo, and you can download this.
Who knew?
I don't know why that went to the other
one. We'll figure it out.
We can click there to start to download. So you download this to your computer. And then you just run it from your computer. It's that easy to do. And you know, Kim always gets upset when I do this.
Now, will this run on a PC and a Mac?
Apparently, we just have Windows in the screen there. So
that's
the only thing
it
said. It may only be for Windows. The price is right.
Free?
Free is definitely working for me.
Maybe free with a rebate?
But they have an advanced version, too, that you can unlock. So we're just going through this real quick here. But look at how you can do word searches, too. Mm-hmm. So they have a lot of variations. And you can go through this and different kinds of things.
Quick tour. That's
you
nice.
Can even post it on the web. So you have options. You don't have to hand
it
out
on
paper.
So it's social. Other people can benefit from what you do.
Yeah, our teachers could actually put it on their Edline page. You can add colors to it. And get through all these things.
That's so you don't have to reinvent the wheel if someone else has created. Nice.
A lot of nice things. So we're going to be back in a little bit. We're going to show you some new cool sites on Palm Breeze Cafe. So don't go anywhere.
Don't go.